Sadly, that happens all of the time. Each year, all around the world, there are several of millions of birds death from collision with power lines and electrocutions.
Under these poles, we have identified tens of killed birds, many storks, buzzards, kestrels, and also magpies. And we can call it killer poles that were responsible for many carcasses of raptors and other species.
We went to Slovakia to join Mark and Eva from Danube Free Sky to see what we can do to protect them. Power lines is something new for the birds. They haven't had enough time to adapt to these man-made structures, which crossing their habitats. And they are killing more than 10,000 birds each year in Slovakia alone. That's why it's our responsibility to protect birds from these threats.
The mortality of young swans is higher when we compare it to older swans, but I think it's connected that usually the young swans are in the middle or at the end of the flock. If you're in the middle or at the end, everything what you see is only the swan in front of you or nearby you. The swans don't have enough time to change the level or change the direction.
It's a sunset right now and we arrive at the feeding ground of the swans. There's quite a huge flock. Soon they will fly over the electric lines to the roosting site, and it's quite a dangerous place. Here's no diverters and we're gonna monitor what's gonna happen, because most of the collision happens at the low light, either very early or before the sunset. This time, all of the swans passed safely. But when we got closer, we found out that some time ago, it was a bit different story.
So we found this carcass of a swan here. Well, you can tell it's been here for a while. You can see the feathers, they're scattered everywhere. My first impression was that it was from the collision, but those are the animals that have eaten the swan, and that's why the feathers are all around. We just saw some swans passing by, and some of them were really close to the line, so this seems like a dangerous area.
If we identify some carcasses under the pole or under the line, it's always a pity that something like this happened. But on the other hand, all these carcasses help us to increase the safety of power lines, also help us to identify some risky sections and to protect the birds from electrocution. And hundreds of kilometers of lines are now marked with special devices called diverters. It can rotate during the wind. When it's rotating, it looks like it's blinking, so the whole line more visible for flying birds. And during the night, this is glowing up to 8 to 10 hours. This is another type of diverter, and also this white bar can be charged during the day and glow in the dark, so it's shaking during the wind. We have observed that both have more than 90% efficiency.
And that's exactly why we're meeting Franček and Josef, who developed a unique drone specially designed for installing bird diverters. Have a look at this controller, batteries and other parts. With all of that, they can install up to 300 diverters in one day. And they can do it on a live wire, meaning they don't need to disconnect electric line.
How do you put it? So,
like this. It's close and then I hit the cable.
So I'm checking distance between the installed diverters, but also vertical speed, because from the underline there are optical illusions. There are too many lights, but also when drone is going up and far, you don't know if it's going in this direction or up direction. So that's my job to navigate in.
The second mortality factor is the problem of electrocution. This is connected mainly with the raptors. The raptor connect two phases during the landing, but sometimes the birds are also killed after the fall from the pole, because it's about 10 to 12 meters. Distribution poles often substitute the natural perches like trees and shrubs. That's why these poles are the only place where the raptors can sit and can perch or look for their prey. That's why the electricity company, they are using plastic devices or plastic components. They can cover these dangerous parts on the cross arm.
But there's also another and quite unexpected solution.
Here behind me the grasslands which been rewilded, and from this side is normal agricultural land, completely dry monoculture. It's a, such a huge difference. Here I can hear so many birds and a lot of insects and crickets, and here's basically nothing.
The aim is to transform former arable land to the grassland to provide better conditions for insects and small mammals, and better conditions for birds of prey for nesting and feeding. There is also like no dangers for birds of prey in terms of medium voltage poles.
To save the birds, you really have to take care of the land first.
Yeah, exactly, and not use many chemicals and pesticides. You can also hear the difference because there is some buzzing with with some insects.
That's exactly where a lot of problems come from when we destroy our biodiversity. And everything is interconnected, and at the end it also affects us humans. And yeah, by protecting birds, by providing habitat, you're taking care about everything, and that's the way to go. Electric poles can also provide a habitat for birds. So there, behind me, there's a huge power line and there's a nest box for falcons, but in this one, owl and three chicks.
It's great to know that we can adapt even such huge and industrial structure for birds. In other words, there's a lot of what we can do. We just need the will of doing something and then act on it.
Here's a similar video I did in Bulgaria, but with pelicans. And thank you for watching. If you like our videos, subscribe to our channel, support us on Patreon, and be brave to act.